Vauxhall Mokka in for a bronze this morning. Not in the best of conditions, as you can see. Not too dirty of an exterior, fortunately. So it's going to be around about an hour and a half, maybe 2 hours. We'll get straight cracking on with it. Let's get to work.
Foaming that down. I just wanted to let you guys know that this is going to become a fairly frequent thing. We did want to start the YouTube channel for a while now. Main thing is just ideas, so we're going to obviously be showcasing a lot of cars we can do these out, from Porsches to Vauxhalls, all the way to the Lamborghinis and the Bentleys. We'll be displaying everything. We're going to be doing a fair few long form videos. We're also going to be doing a lot of shorts, so make sure you head to the link below where you can follow us on TikTok, Facebook, Instagram, all of the social media, showing us support. We really, really do appreciate it. But back to the detail.
I don't know if that's top detail.
Haircut's looking a bit dodgy at the minute. Will's just finishing up washing the exterior. We're going to get it rinsed, dried and protected with some Lucas spray wax, and then we're going to crack straight on with the interior. Right, so she's finally all nicely washed. We're just going to have to dress the trim and tyres at the end. We are going to crack straight on with the interior now, as we have got another appointment to get to. So I will just be showing some shots once it's all done and dusted. But we've got ahead and applied our Lucas spray wax to the exterior, as you can tell. She's now looking lovely. Will's just going around doing the final bits, doing some of the exterior glass. But the car's looking a million and one times better already. But like we say, we're going to crack straight on with the interior, get it all vacuumed out, do a wipe down of all the plastics and everything. But you can tell it's not in the best condition, but certainly not the worst compared to what we're used to seeing. There's a dog let in the back, so it's not really too dirty. But like we say, give it a good wipe down, clean over all the glass and everything, give the leather a good clean. Don't ever miss these little bits in your seats. But yeah, this is a regular client. He gets his cars down every 2 to 3 weeks, so they're never too dirty. But we'll get it all wrapped up and we'll show you guys the final results. So why Will's doing the hoovering, this is normally how we run things when we're carrying out interiors. Obviously, depending on what we're doing to the interior, there's different steps to it. However, this is just bronze, so it's our basic interior and exterior. So it gets a thorough vacuum out and we wipe down all of your leather. And then we do all the plastic and trim, of course. So like I say, Will's currently hoovering the whole car out. He hasn't started on the front just yet. However, I'm just about to begin my wipe down on this section of the car. As you can tell, this section here has already been wiped down and part of the centre console is a bit of a struggle at the minute, as our air hose decided to give on it in on us. so we haven't got an air compressor. However, we should have one by the end of the week. Fingers crossed. If the delivery doesn't take too long. But as I mentioned, Will's carrying out the full vacuum on the interior. Like you say, there's a dog net in the back, so there's not too much dog hair that we have to deal with. However, we do have a bit of fun dealing with dog hair. It does do some wonderful clips as well. But it's not too bad of an interior. Like we say, they get their cars done basically every 2 to 3 weeks. And last time we did this, I believe, was around about 2 weeks ago or so. We're finally having a bit better weather in the UK. We've had some awful weather over the past 2 weeks. Bearing in mind it's currently the 8th of August, so it's meant to be our peak summer at the minute. And yeah, that's the sun. So yeah, we haven't had the best of weather, but any sunshine without rain, or any weather without the rain, we will take it as detailing, as working in the rain is not fun. But like I say, we're going to crack on with this interior. I'll show you guys when we're finished. The whole exterior is now finally all dry. She's looking absolutely lovely now. Got to get these blooming drip marks sorted though. They always tend to happen. But yeah, we're going to get this finished and I'll get back with you. I don't think you guys know how weird it is for me to pick up a camera again. When I was, I don't know, 11, 12, 13, I always focus that. I always just wanted to do YouTube and, I don't know, I kind of got a bit lost with it. To be able to pick up a camera again and show where my life has gone since and the business that I now run is wonderful. There's a lot of big things coming. This is very early stages, and I say early. We used to walk around with a shopping trolley. I now have 2 vans and 4 members of staff, so we have come a long way, but we're nowhere near finished. I want 50 vans and I want 10 workshops. I really want to build a massive company. It's always been my dream. So this YouTube series, or channel should I say, will hopefully document the entire growth journey of the business. We want to see where this takes us as well. We've got a fair few fun things planned. So sometime this year we're going to be doing a track day with all the members of the team. We're going to go down to Silverstone and race some McLarens and Ferraris and things like that. And then next year, mid next year, so this time next year, I'd say me and Will, we're going to be driving down to Germany to race on the Nürburgring. Once we get our cars, I'm going to be getting a BMW 1 Series. So I'm very excited for that. Being young, the insurance is not the best. I got quoted £6,000 for my insurance at the minute, so we're gonna put it on pause just till I get some no claims discounts, as I am only 18. I've been driving for around about 8 months. These things are £5,000 a year to insure as it is. So we're gonna put the BMW on pause.
And once the insurance goes down a little bit, that's when we'll look at getting the BMW and getting it all kitted up and modded and ready for a track. Like I said, I'm gonna get this interior all finished. I'll see you guys in a minute. Right, well, fairly stupidly, I've got a full SD card, so I've got to try and get as much footage as I can. I've just realised that after we have got this Peugeot here, after the Ford Fiesta, and don't quote me on that because I got it wrong on this one, but I believe we've got a Ford Fiesta next in for a silver, so we've got to clean all of the seats, carpets, upholstery. We're just finishing up now on the interior of this one, looking a million and one times better. We just got to do all the trim. So we always like to dress the door seals. Leaves a very new feeling to the car. And then we just got to dress all of these shuts and piece the trim. You'll notice on these cars, like, it looks like the trim's still dirty. It's just where it begins to fade. Obviously, someone's previously used acid here, as you can see. However, we just got to dress all the tires, dress with the trim, dress under in those wheel wells, and we'll be all sorted. We'll back there, just finishing it all up, gonna get all the tyres and trim dressed now, and we shall be sorted. It's looking a million times better now though, everything's all gone. Did a wonderful job on the boot too, all looking brand spanking new, as it should, as it should.
Yeah, I took water, sold it in bottles for $2. The Coca-Cola came and bought it for $3.